morning, one and all. My name is Anita Sheila, working as an assistant professor, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I will go to explain the types of laser. There are many types of lasers in various industries, mechanical and commercial and electrical. So many types of lasers are available nowadays. So they depends on lasing material. Types of lasers 5. Solid state lasers, gas lasers, excimer lasers, dye lasers. Semiconductor lasers. Now, solid state lasing. What is solid state laser? The lasing action, the lasing material in the lasing action is solid material. That is called solid state laser. The laser emitting of wavelength is 6943 angstroms. And example of gas solid laser is ruby laser. Gas laser is consist of lasing action in the medium. Active medium is gas, that is helium, neon or carbon dioxide laser. The laser emits the light near wavelength is 6 to 93 angstroms. Next, excimer laser. In the meaning of excimer, it is called a dimmer. Dimmer laser, the combination of reactive gases and inert gases, means fluorine, chlorine, reactive gases, inert gases, xenon, neon, this type of gases mixed with the form excimer laser. This range is ultraviolet range of wavelength. Next, dye laser. Dye laser is the 60 liquid pattern lasers. This range is large range application is wavelength. Next, semiconductor laser is called diode laser. This is example is printers. Semiconductor printer lasers, and low power input is given to the laser action. The semiconductor works the laser. Now, I want to explain the detail of ruby laser. Ruby laser is belongs to the solid state laser. Ruby laser construction and working principle. What is ruby laser? Ruby laser belongs to solid state laser. So mainly laser is 4 components. Mainly components are active medium, active source, and active element. And lasing source vachese so lasing source consider as a xenon helical lamp. medium is considered as ruby rod. And in that ruby laser, main thing is aluminum oxide plus chromium ions, combination of chromium ions from the ruby laser. So ruby, meaning of ruby is called pink. So chromium, characteristic of chromium also red color. So that red color is observed only green and blue colors. Green and blue colors. Pumping. Pumping source. Types of laser include types of laser, solid state laser. The in that pumping, four major important things having the laser: active medium, active element, and laser source and pumping source. In that ruby laser, pumping source considered as a ruby rod. Ruby rod consists of both ends silver polished. That is, that is considered as pumping source. First we have to take the construction of laser, ruby laser. First we have to take the ruby rod. This is made up of aluminium oxide plus chromium ions. So chromium ions only active elements, because chromium is the active element in this ruby laser. So this arrangement is 4 cm of ruby laser and 0.5 cm of diameter, that is ruby rod taking, and two ends polished by the silver glitter, silver coating. So one end is polished 100%, means fully reflective. Another end is partially reflective. Partially reflective. Taking another glass medium. This is purpose of cooling. This is purpose of cooling. Total arrangement is called active medium. Next, optical source is considered as one light source, that is helically xenon lamp. That is shape is spherical shape. This cooling is useful for when the system is xenon lamp. So this xenon lamp consists of capacitor. This capacitor is discharging mode. The system will work on position. This capacitor is on charging mode. The system is off position. The Ruby laser is three-level pumping system. This is the construction of Ruby laser. One is active medium, cooling system, active source and active elements. Next. Three-level system. That first, we have considered the three levels. Energy states, E1 energy state is ground state, E2 and E3 is, this is highly excited state, this is excited state. First, consider when atom is in ground state, it will, from power supply is optical pumping is started in the system, then only power start the system. That time the helical lamp bright. So then the helical lamp color is white color. In that white color observed by the chromium only blue or green color. Okay. Then atom will observe only blue or green color light. Blue or green color light. The atom will transition from ground state to excited state. This is 10 power minus 8 seconds. This is lifetime of atom in the excited state. After completing the lifetime, it will move to the next level. That is metastable state. This is ground state. This is excited state. So three states in that the atoms will exit a state after completing the lifetime, they move to E2 level. That E2 level is sitting compared to lifetime of E2 level E3, the lifetime is maximum. When compare the number of atoms E1 and E2, from optical pumping is possible to population inversion because of number of atoms in E2 level is more compared to E1. Then N2 is greater than 2. N1 is only possible the population inversion. The atoms will may on stimulated emission. Involved in the stimulated emission, the time for energy will emit. So, in the form of photons. One photon emit the system. Then it will again transition and again emission in the process. Every time increase the energy. Like 1, 2, 4. Every photon in step by step increase the intensity of light. Every time. Then this is the satisfy the stimulated emission of radiation. So this is a working principle of Ruby laser. So Ruby laser is one have disadvantage. That is the system is maximum heating is occurs in the light on position. So that is the major disadvantage that is resolved by the helium neon laser.
Thank you. 30 minutes 50.